We'll spin this one on there. Gets to there, and it's not going to go anywhere without chewing both of them up. Once these are chewed up, backing off, sometimes it chews up the whole rest of the wheel stud.
Let's test our 5 newly corrected wheel studs and lug nuts.
Anyway, these were both a mess. Start it by hand, as one should. Spins all the way.
Brian's Mobile One.
It's one of those deals where you start working on the car, you go to pull the lug nuts off, and instead of just zew, they go the whole way out, and you're just like, crap. You see those threads right there? How they're just all buggered up? So what we're going to do is take this guy and clean them up. This is an M12 by 1.25. They're kind of rare in tap and die set. I ground it around because there's nothing I could do to get it to work on the thing that I was working on, because I couldn't go on from the end because the end was messed up. So I wanted to start before the end where the threads were nice and then back it out over that. It worked really good for that. So what you do to make one of these is you just grind it where you want it to break, but you have to have that support still in there, otherwise it won't work because it'll collapse and they won't align properly.
I'm not afraid to customize my tools because oftentimes the original intended use for it is still valid. Let me show you on this one how I'm going to do that. I'm going to secure it in a socket, either 1 inch or 25 millimeter, use a little hot glue, and we'll be good to go.
Anyway, I just thought I'd showcase that because it's ghetto and I want everybody to think I'm... No, because it's actually a really handy tip and it can save your butt.
This little part of this video is just a little side tip that I thought would help somebody, so I left it in.
Ta-da! And now I can get it into the tight squeeze that I need to get it into. Let me show you. What do you guys think? Let me get this on a little bit first. Then I'm going to try to attempt to straighten my socket, make it more square.
I don't use a T-handle to drive the die because it'll hit on the neighboring wheel studs.
Anyway, I already ordered the brake pads. This thing's trying to get on a trip. It's one of the last minute things, trying to get it done quick for somebody and make sure that they do it safe. Now we're cutting threads. You can use cutting oil. There's nothing wrong with doing that. You don't necessarily have to. All I'm doing is chasing threads. I'm not cutting new threads the whole way. So I'm just going to run this until it bottoms out, just like that, and then back it off. This can save you from ruining a new lug nut. Can save you from messing all kinds of stuff up. So I'm going to get rid of this guy.
Ideally, the customer would already know all of these things and schedule ahead brake pads and wheel studs and all the stuff to do it right, but give them the last minute, get her done.
One of those waste not, want not kind of things. I think what happened, this has new aftermarket wheels, and a bunch of these were affected, like the wheel came off and chewed them up all the way down in there. See, look at that, it looks beautiful. This was my test pilot before, is the specialized lug nut, and I couldn't get it on past here, it would just hang up. Now it goes on nice and clean. Most every Haynes manual, back in the day you got Hilton, Paris Hilton's dad, yeah. No, you got all kinds of different manuals, and they all say at the beginning to have some type of means of correcting threads. So this one was really bad. I cut the threads out here because I just thought it would just be just the one, it'd just be real quick. And you can float over that if you have threads all the way around it the rest of the way. Anyway, this was the worst of them. It was so chewed up. So sometimes you gotta back off if it cuts threads into something real deep and it starts to bind. You gotta go backwards for a second. Anyway, I don't have a 25 millimeter socket handy and I don't ever use my SAE kit really, but this 1 inch came in real handy. That came from Harbor Freight. Glad to have it, picked it up cheap. I think it was like one of those partial ones where they had to warranty it out for somebody. Oh, that feels so good. I love clean threads. I hate broken off bolts. I hate messed up fasteners because you never account for that labor time or just budgeting time of what you can do in a day. If you have tools and tricks like this in your arsenal, you can blast through it in minutes instead of having to, you know, call in another order, get some wheel studs, tear everything down further. You can just do this and avoid all of that. I love it. such a time and money saver. There's no way on earth this would ever get on there without an impact, just driving it on like the guy did. I just chewed the lug nut all the crap. I'm going to show you how I fix the lug nut, just because I don't have access to another one, because they're aluminum rim, weird air, acorn kind of style. Anyway, we'll just chase all of them. Now that I'm all set up for this, it's pretty quick and easy to do. I'm really happy the way it's turning out. It's one of those tricks I don't do very often because I'm not in a hurry and don't just let it sit forever while I wait for the right parts to come in. And this one I'm trying to do as cheap and fast as possible. So it's not the right way to do it necessarily. I mean, it kind of is if you ask me. Not the right way, but it is cheap and fast. You want it right, cheap, or fast. Pick two. If you want it to be fast and cheap, it's not going to be right. If you want it to be right and fast, it's not going to be cheap. And if you want it cheap and right, it's not going to be fast. It's kind of a business management strategy so you don't burn yourself out and go broke at the same time. Well, there we have it. All these threads are cleaned up and fixed. I thought it was just these two. Turns out all five were pretty messed up. Now I'm going to get a bolt and cut some flutes in it because I don't have M12 by 1.25 tap. Those are kind of rare. But I can get a M12 by 1.25 bolt, kind of helical, curve cut it, and make something to chase the lug nuts with. I'll do that in the vise. So how did I know what the thread was on these anyway? So here's my bad lug nuts. I'm willing to bet that all of them are a little bit jacked up. This one is probably one of the best. Only the best of you. Okay, this one's jacked all the crap. This one is worse than that. So anyway, we're going to go through all four of these. I'm going to put them in a vise and just run through them backwards. If I just go through with this type of fastener, and how did I know what size they were? I just took one of these. I picked the best one. It's this guy. Not great. These are all rusted and cankered from all kinds of dissimilar metal stuff. But I've got these metric check-a-thread and inch check-a-thread. These were displays, and they got busted off at Napa. So anyway, they can order fixtures for their place. And you can ask them, hey, can you order me one of those? Because that's what I was asking the guy. He's like, oh, we're just going to get new ones anyway. You can just have those. I'm like, heck yeah. There you go. M12 by 1.25. And then this bolt, we'll just double check that, because double checking can save all kinds of grief. It's a great habit to double check things. Be humble, curb your ego, kind of deal. Anyway, I save all kinds of nuts and bolts. Probably one of the bolts that I'm using came from a vehicle that got junked, or it came from an engine or something that was a core. You pay $50 for a core for an engine, a cheap one. Keep stuff, waste not, want not. Don't throw this crap away. All this stuff was destined for the garbage. And today it's saving my bacon. So we're going to make a thread chaser out of this. First thing we need to do is get this switched out. There's a button on the back that holds it in place. Buddy had a Ryobi one of these, and he's asking for some help on getting the... No, I think I dropped in on him. I butted into his life, and I was like, what you up to? I'm like, he's cutting rebar. He's like, but I can't get this thing off. On the Ryobi one, I tried to get it loose, and there's just nothing doing. I actually bent the wrench. This one, no matter how hard I tighten it, the wrench is strong enough. These are good enough. The things on this were starting to strip on the Ryobi. I'm like, dude, you need a Milwaukee. And he's like, oh, whatever, fanboy, you know, Ford Chevy stuff. I'm like, no, for real, huge difference. Grab one of my old discs. I don't need anything real long or else it can get in the way because of the shoulder of this. You see how these line up like this? Let's get in there. Get right in there. So I need to cut these, but I don't want to have a real big diameter. I'll get into this too. The threads on this are cut this way. So they're basically going at this angle. So I'm going to cut some relief cuts here and here for filings to go into. And then we're going to lube it up with my secret weapon. We're going to cut these lug nuts. Another really great thing about these is that they don't kick back. They don't grab onto stuff and about rip your arm off like my Hitachi that plugs in. Really crank this sucker in there to stay. All right, so it's got to go this way, flip it over and do the same. So the main thing I'm doing is I'm creating a space, creating a room for all the shavings to go. This bolt's a good bolt. It's a grade 5 or higher. Japanese, it's got all kinds of good coating on it. Built to last. Normally I do them really steep. The only thing you really gotta be careful of is you don't want to do it where your first thread starts. You can see I did this on just the side of it. Thread starts in this middle section, and that just helps you to get the thing started. All right, let's do some lug nuts. Where's the special sauce? So let's show you a before. Here is just a normal bolt. It's in good shape. We'll spin it down. This one's pretty buggered up at the end of it. Should be able to spin it through by hand. You get to here and it's starting to chew it up. And now it's not working at all. It's just buggered. So if I keep going, it'll chew up the threads on the bolt. This stuff's really light. It's not cutting oil per se, but it is just really a good lubricant. So I'm just gonna slap some of this foment into the groove. I don't wanna hose my whole workbench down, so I'm being really cautious here. Ta-da! I'm telling you, this ain't so hard, it ain't so bad. Normally go pretty slow for a video. I think it bores people and I get the work done slower. I'm telling you, I can't wait till I'm done filming so I can listen to music again. It just blew right through that. Let's get another one of these and show you the proof that it worked. All right. And we're not gonna hold on to it. We're just gonna do it the way we did the other ones. Things just flying right through, all the way through, no big deal. I think this makes such a difference. I've got to make sure that I get rid of this, get it sprayed out with some brake parts cleaner. I think that will take it out because we want some friction on these things. So easy, so fast. Yes, I sell it. Yes, I get a little commission, but I freaking love that stuff. I was the biggest naysayer critic. It took me a year and a half before I'd even listen to the guy about it. He's like, you've got a YouTube channel? You do automotive stuff? Oh man, you're gonna love this. Heard that before. I'm like, you know that stuff's snake oil, right? That one was a little aggressive. This is the worst one. Just gonna put a little bit of this on there. This stuff doesn't last forever. Like, I put it on door hinges and stuff. And they squeak again within, you know, weeks. Okay, I'm through. Alright, this one was four shits old. So I'm gonna get that down close because I'm in a hurry. Why we're doing this, trying to save time, right? It's a little chewy at the bottom, just a little bit, but you can still get it to go in by hand. These are not going to chew up the wheel stud anymore. I'm done. Time to spray out the lubricant and put them together. All right, I've got four chewed up wheel studs that have been thread chased, and I've got four really chewed up wheel studs. Wheel studs and lug nuts. Anyway, these were both a mess. Start it by hand, as one should. Spins all the way. That was the worst one on the worst one. And they've got plenty of threads. There's no rattle to them. Teeny tiny rattle on just about any lug nut. Unless they're buggered up. It's so much better than it was. I don't know why I take the time salvaging the things I do. And then I remember, oh yeah, it's a 20-minute trip each way to get these things. 25 minutes, and that's with no traffic. Look at that. Sweet. I'm satisfied. That's a good fix. It's not perfect, but it's cheap and it's fast.